We recognize that no computer system is perfectly secure. So we invest heavily in an assumed breach approach, where we prepare for emerging threats by assuming that the system's gonna get compromised. So as part of our investments, we invest heavily in big data analytics and machine learning to identify and target anomalous behavior. And then we use deep forensics tools to hunt across the service, looking for potential compromises. And we also employ a dedicated team of penetration testers to find and fix security vulnerabilities.
I lead the Office 365 Red Team. You can think of us as an internal team of hackers focused on protecting Office 365. My team is composed of professionals with a variety of different backgrounds: developers, testers, network specialists, some from inside of Microsoft, some from government, others from private industry. We think and act like the adversaries that might attack our service or our customers. We analyze and probe the service for vulnerabilities. We track the latest emerging threats and trends to better simulate attack scenarios for Office 365. My team has significant freedom to be creative in our techniques, but at the same time, we have to adhere to some clear rules of engagement.
Importantly, we're careful not to place customer data at risk. We only target our own data in the service. We're careful not to impact the availability. And we're careful not to weaken any in-place security as it exists today. A typical simulated attack comprises of three major stages. The team starts with reconnaissance, probing the surface area of the service for potential vulnerabilities. Then they move into exploitation, where they try to exploit any discovered vulnerabilities and weaknesses in the service. And lastly, if they've made it through the first two, they'll try to access representative data during the data access phase to show that they can.
During reconnaissance, we try to gather as much info as we can about that service that we're targeting. So we'll look at endpoints that are serving customer data. We may target web applications and try to get malicious code running through those, either through via injection attacks like SQL injection, command injection, PowerShell injection, or other means. And when we discover a vulnerability, that's when we validate our assumed breach readiness through exploitation. So at this point, we want to get at the data, which is ultimately our goal. We're going to try to bypass any protections that might be in place. We're going to try to not get caught. We're looking for anything to help us get at that goal.
We use advanced TTPs, or tactics, techniques, and procedures, of real adversaries that we've ripped from the news and that we know from research. We'll use sophisticated command and control infrastructure, system-level persistence.
And we're a Windows shop, so you'll use well-known Windows post-exploitation techniques like pass the hash, pass the ticket, and other credential theft. So all the while, we're trying to stay forensically clean and remain undiscovered in the environment by covering our tracks wherever we can. That's one scenario that Office 365 has to face. We'll also simulate other kinds of attacks as well. This includes spear phishing against service operators, insider attacks. We'll even leverage cross-site scripting and other types of client-side attacks to properly represent what an attacker might do.
We know that the red team attacks are as real as possible. We'll be able to harden the Office 365 service in the face of real attackers. Balancing the red team is the blue team, whose job it is to detect and remediate their attacks on the service.
When the blue team detects us, then that's when the cat and mouse game really starts. We try to stealthily access data while the blue team works to defend and kick us out of the service. We treat the exercise as a real incident until the blue team figures out it is us through investigation.
Both the red and the blue teams work together with engineering to fix and harden the service. All of this effort in simulating sophisticated attacks helps us to improve our detections of malicious activity and also evolve our algorithms and response capabilities.
We know that if we continuously validate the security of the service, we can stay ahead of emerging threats.